Welcome to the Red Vault. Today we will compare the father with the son. In this video, we will compare one of the most iconic amplifier with its successor. Our first amplifier is PV6505, and it's the made in USA 120 watt version from 90s. You know, in these days, they are making these products in China under the name 1992 OG, but today we have the actual OG, and we will compare this thing with its successor, which is EVH5153. It's the EL34 stealth 100 watt version, and our main difference is we have 6L6 tubes on the power section of the 6505, and we have EL34 tubes on the power amp section of 5150. But for now, I don't want to get lost on the specifications. I want to make this comparison because I was looking for a PV, an old PV, because it can be the best amplifier for me, especially for my playing, especially for my metal enthusiasm. And then I went to Italy and I purchased this 5150. It's a current production and it was on sale, but still, before actually purchasing it, I had some hesitations about its tone because I'm not into those mix ready modern amplifiers. Actually, I like the noises of old amplifiers because I believe they add some texture. And then to end my hesitations, I watched some comparison videos between these two amplifiers. Then I decided the blue channel of the EVH5150 is quite similar to the old 6505, which is the equivalent of old 5150, and then I purchased the EVH5150, and then I played it and I recorded and I shot a review video of it, and simply I really enjoyed every moment of it. And today I compared these two amplifiers, and I'm shooting this video with the comfort of achieving something nice, something good, something satisfying, at least for me, because the result of the comparison was just how I expected, but I don't want to influence you at this moment. Also, you can find the no talking version of this video too, but I think it's too late to mention it. But if you are still watching, thank you for bearing with me, and I hope you already subscribed the channel and liked the video. And now let's talk about our amplifiers briefly, and then let me explain the recording and comparison procedure with the gear, and then we will check the comparison audio. Actually, on the specification section, I don't want to mention every specs of these amplifiers, because if you are watching this video, probably you already knew the amount of the tubes or the FX loop or the speaker outputs, etc. It's boring, but our main difference is we have two channel on this PV6505 with high and normal gain inputs. And design wise, we have some differences on this 5150. We have a single input with three different channels. The red channel of this 5150 has the true modern metal sound. It's the blue channel on steroid, and I think it's too much for me. It's too much for my way of doing stuff. Also, we have nothing sounds like on this 6505. So today we will compare the blue channel of this 5150 with the red channel, the lead channel of the 6505. Also, I think this video will kind of represent the effect of the power tubes. You know, we have 6L6 tubes on this thing and we have EL34s on this 5150. I know to represent this effect, comparing this thing with the 6L6 version or comparing this thing with 6534 would be better, but today we have these amplifiers. And I will play these amplifiers with my Jackson King V Pro Dave Mustaine Signature. This thing has a poplar body with maple neck and ebony fretboard. Also, we have Jackson J80C pickup, and we are on E standard tuning. And the signal of these amplifiers go to my Mesa Rectifier 4x12 standard cabinet. And I have a Shure SM57, which is placed as half cap and half con. And the signal of that microphone comes to my Focusrite 18i20 audio interface. And first, we will compare them in the mix, and then we will hear them with dual tracks without any post process, and then we will hear the audio of this amplifier as mono tracks without any post process again, and we will compare them at noon, boosted noon, and 666 and boosted 666. Also, I dialed these amplifiers which fits to my taste, and we will compare them with that approach also. And now, enough talking, let's hear it. then let's hear them again without drums and bass and without the post-process. Just one more time, now let's hear them as mono tracks.
Thank you.
Welcome back. I hope this comparison will satisfy you too, because it really satisfied me. You know, just as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, I purchased this amplifier with some hesitation because I was able to compare them only with some YouTube videos. But after this comparison, I'm really happy because, you know, both of these amplifiers still have the same DNA no matter the brand. Both of these brands secured and protected the very essence of the first 5150. But in this EVH5150, in addition, we have a red channel. So if you want something compact which contains both old and new, this EL34 or maybe the 6L6 version, by the way, I'm not happy with the 6L6 version of the new EVH5150. I would go with EL34 in any circumstances. But with something like this, you can have both old and new at the same time. But if you have no interest on the modern stuff, and if you are able to find one for a better deal compared to this EVH5150, you won't lose a thing. But no matter what, they are not the exact copies. We have some differences on their sound, on their characteristics. While there is no boost, both of them act quite similar. But when there is boost, the harshness, the aggression, especially on the top end, kinda better on this 5152. But also the control of the 6505 can be beneficial as well. Also, I think the low end of the 6505 kinda a little bit of flabby compared to the 5150, but unlike my latest comparison, which is 6505 versus 6505 mini-head, the differences between these amplifiers are totally negligible, and you can match these with some touches on the front panel. I'm not mentioning the post-process, because I know with some post-process you can match different sources, but also those post-process touches will take away all of the nuances, the beauty of the old tube amplifiers as well. But with one of these amplifiers and with a nice cabinet and a simple Shure SM57, you can get just what you want. You shouldn't purchase one of these if you already have the other one. And besides that, there is nothing else to say. I hope you enjoyed the comparison, and if you enjoyed, please don't forget to like the video, subscribe the channel, and please don't forget to leave your opinions in the comment section. Till the next video, see ya.